In the Kyoto Protocol, a market mechanism was established where a developed country could invest in a developing country in some key area to reduce their emissions of greenhouse gases. But the credit would then go to the country which actually invested in it. Now, in the case of the Paris Agreement, all countries would be on the same par, and some countries have said that on their own, within their own national boundaries, they cannot reduce their greenhouse gases enough. They would then buy those credits generated by another country who have exceeded what they have done, and then use that to meet their needs. So for example, a country like Belize, where we might be able to generate more credits because of our forest resources, our use of renewable energy. If we exceeded what we said we would do, we could sell it to a country that does not meet it. But then obviously Belize can't claim credit for reducing a 1,000 tons, mm-hmm. and the other country say, and I reduce 1,000 tons because I got it from Belize, so I get 2,000, and the atmosphere only sees one. So that's the kind of double counting we want to ensure doesn't happen, because then the atmosphere will not feel it, and small island states who are feeling the impacts of climate change would feel it.